Hey everyone, Phil here from Support at Missive. In this deep dive video, we'll talk about the differences between archiving and closing in Missive. But first, we have to talk about assignments, because without them, the closing feature in Missive would not exist. So in Missive, a conversation can have one of the three assignment states. Just no assignments, that's the first one. Like this email here, personal email I got in my private email account, nothing is assigned. Or this conversation here, I just created it like this, and it's not assigned. Then a conversation can be assigned to a team inbox. So these here, they're in the support team inbox. The team inbox serves as a triaging step before someone handles the customer inquiry. For example, if your support team receives an email that should be handled by the development team, you can move that conversation to their team inbox, allowing the developers to decide who should reply. Like this one here, question for developers, I can either assign to me, but here I'll just move this from the support team inbox to the developers team inbox, like this. And now it's out of here, and it's for the developers to handle, as I said. And if it's not assigned to a team inbox, then it has to be assigned to a user, an individual, you, or a coworker. You can assign both personal conversations and conversations in a team inbox to specific people. So you will see here, when a conversation is not assigned, like this one, and I decide to reply to this, it's not in team inbox, I just decide to hit reply. You see it says you create a draft and no assignment is created. Then replying to this message gives me the option between send and archive and send, or send and snooze, of course. But basically those are the main ones we'll focus on, send and archive and send. So if I decide to send and archive this conversation, it will get out of my personal inbox and it'll still be available in my all section to see. If I decide to select send, then that conversation will keep being in my inbox until I archive it. When the conversation is in a team inbox though, how it's assigned to a user when they reply will depend on your assignment options. And those assignment options we can check when we click on our avatar, and then settings, teams, and here we're interested in the support team. Edit, scroll to the bottom, assignment options. When a user replies to a message in the team inbox, should it assign the conversation to the user? So it moves away from the support team inbox, goes into their inbox and in their assign to me section. Or the other option is leave conversation in the team inbox. So here you're not assigning conversations to users, you're just leaving them where they were. Second option, when receiving reply in assigned conversations. So let's say you have this one on, assign conversation to user. When you get a new reply after you've already assigned a conversation, should the conversation move back to the assignee's assigned to me section and inbox, or should it just move back to the team inbox? Different teams have different needs, but here I'll focus on assign conversation to user and move conversation to the assignee's assigned to me and inbox, because that's the default state in Missive. Let's hit save. Let's exit. So going back to the team inbox now, let's reply to this conversation. I hit reply, or I could do command R or control R on my computer. Now you see it says, you created this draft, you assigned yourself because of my assignment options. And now that conversation is not in the support team inbox anymore. We had two, now we have one. In my inbox, I have five conversations, and in my assigned to me, I have two now, in my tasks as well. So tasks and assigned to me are just two different ways of seeing everything you're supposed to handle, everything that's assigned to you. Either it's a task inside a conversation, more on that in another video maybe, or assigned conversations like this one here. Now you can see at the top of the conversation, it says close. And that's because someone, me, is assigned to this conversation. Since I'm assigned to this, I'm the one who needs to deal with this conversation. If I close this, I close the assignment, which also has the effect of archiving the conversation. So if you close, it archives. However, you can archive the conversation from your personal inbox without closing the assignment. Let's say you're assigned to this, but you don't want to reply now. Let's discard the draft for now. I'm still assigned. When I go to my inbox, I see this conversation here. I just want to get it out of my inbox. I'll deal with it later, like in a month. So to archive this conversation, I have two options. I can either click here, archive from my inbox, or I can hit the delete key on my keyboard. Let's use the shortcut here. Oh, this box showed up. because it sees you're assigned to this conversation and you're trying to archive the conversation. So it asks you, do you want to just archive the conversation and leave the assignment open in your assigned to me? Or do you want to archive and close, meaning remove from your inbox, but also close the assignment, meaning you're done with it. You don't need to do anything else on that conversation. So let's see, if I archive, now it's out of my inbox, but it's still in my assigned to me. So I can go back to it if I need to, and I can add it back to my inbox if I want to focus on that later on. So let's put back this conversation in my inbox now, because I want to show you the snooze, which is like a temporary archive in a way. So I'm on this conversation, it's in my inbox. I could, as I did before, like just archive it and have it still be in my assigned to me. But if I snooze, what I'm doing is I'm removing from my inbox and it will reopen in my inbox at a later date. So let's snooze this now, later today. Now it's out of my inbox and I can go in all if I want to see this conversation here. If I need to focus on all the snooze conversations I can see, I can click on pin to sidebar, main section, and then see all my snooze conversations here. And as soon as that snooze is done, it'll just reopen in my inbox. But you can still see it here in my assigned to me section because I never closed the assignment. I just snoozed the conversation. So this principle works the same when you send an email. And that's usually where people are confused because they will see different buttons. So I'm just unsnoozing this now, putting it back in my inbox, and I'm going to hit reply. I have the send and close button here, but if I decide to just use send, what I'm doing is the conversation stays exactly where it was in my inbox and in my open assignments. I'm just sending a new email in that conversation, but the state of where it's located stays the same. If I send an archive, then it's out of my inbox, but I didn't close the conversation, so the assignment is still open in my assigned to me section. Let's see what happens if I do this. Same thing, not in my inbox anymore, still in my assigned to me. And then if I decide to send and close, I'm removing the conversation from my inbox and I'm closing the assignment. So it's not open in my assigned to me section anymore. Send and close. Now we see out of my assignments and my tasks and out of my inbox. So this is what happens when a conversation is open. You have send and archive, send and close, send. But what are the options when I send an email on a conversation that's already archived or closed? Let's try it first with the close button. So let's say I close this email now. It's out of my assigned to me. I'm just going to click here to get back to it. And I want to hit reply now. See what happens. The default button is send. Why is that? Well, there's no send and close to do here because I previously closed the assignment. I have to reopen it in order to send and close. So I can just send an email. I can also do send an archive, but that will have no effect here because that conversation is already closed and archived. Same effect. So now that we've covered the basics of assignments, archiving versus closing, here are a few other points you should know about. Archiving something from your personal inbox is not the same as archiving from the team inbox. Suppose I have this coworker who mentioned me in this conversation. Being mentioned adds that conversation, wherever it's located, into my personal inbox because I'm being mentioned. I'm the one who's named admin. Can you check this? So it's in my personal inbox. If you're not exactly sure where that conversation is, look at the emoji here. When I hover it, it says assigned to developer's team. So I know that I can go in the developer's team inbox and I will find this conversation here. If I archive this conversation from my personal inbox, from here, not from here. I select this conversation and let's say I've reviewed whatever this was about. Good. Then I archive. See what happens. It's out of my personal inbox, but it's still in the team inbox. Then if you archive from the team inbox, you're archiving for everyone. See here, once I do this, and I'm just going to go back to this conversation now, you can see no one is seeing this conversation anywhere visible in Missive unless they search for it. Or I could mention my coworker too here, and you will see now I can hover this profile and see they have this conversation in their inbox. Why is that? It's because I mentioned them. So archiving from the team inbox archives for everyone. But if a conversation is in a personal inbox, it does not archive for that location because that user has this conversation in their personal inbox for a different reason. I mentioned them, or they could be watching the conversation, more on that in another video. But as soon as I would comment, it would appear in their profile or something. But let me make sure I explain that clearly. What you archive from your personal inbox only affects you, not the rest of the team. And what you archive from the team inbox affects everyone. If you assign a conversation to someone, then it's out of the team inbox for everybody else. I know sometimes teams try to, they want to have a view of like the team inbox. They want to see like everything, wherever it is, who's working on what. You have this in the sub mailboxes here. If something is assigned to someone, you will see it under assigned to others. Everything that's assigned to you, you'll see it in the assigned to me section, but also in your personal assigned to me. This is just the sub mailbox of that specific team here. Another thing we'll look at for the technical ones out there, this part is for you. What happens on your email server when you do any of that archiving, assigning, and closing stuff in Missive? Let's see that in action. And for this example, I'll be using the Gmail server of my Missive demo account. So we see here, I have this email that's in my inbox on Gmail, the support email, the one I've been trying to reply to since the beginning of this video. It's in the support team inbox. So it shows up here as well. The team inbox is the inbox in Gmail as well. If I archive this conversation now, like this, I go back to the email server, I'll just refresh here, and now it's out of the inbox in Gmail. However, if I go to all and I move this conversation back to the team inbox, like this, now it's back here, I go back to Gmail, refresh, and now that conversation is here. So if I assign this conversation now to someone like my coworker 2 here, then that conversation is out of the team inbox. If I go back to Gmail, I refresh, that conversation is not in the inbox anymore. And that's because I assigned it to someone else. I assigned it to this coworker. So it's not in the support team inbox anymore. The source of truth shows me that it's in all only and it's not in there. There's a little technical detail about this is that if I had assigned this conversation to myself, that would have happened differently because I am the account owner of missive.sandbox, this email here. So if I go back here and I assign this conversation to myself and I will remove coworker 2 as well. Now this conversation is not in the support team inbox anymore. It's in my personal inbox, but because I'm the account owner, my syncing of the inbox is also reflected into this. So if I go back again to Gmail, then you will see here that the email is in the inbox. That's like a technical detail, but the fact that you are the account owner. And it might explain sometimes why conversation is in the inbox in Gmail or not. But if everyone in your team is using Missive, then looking at the email server should not really matter here. If I decide to now archive this conversation from my inbox, because I am the account owner, my state of the inbox has an effect on Gmail as well. Now it's out of Gmail in my inbox here. Still in my assigned to me again. So this is just a technical detail because if you're going back and forth between your email server and Missive, you may notice these sorts of things are happening because we need to sync that two-way sync with your email server all the time, but it needs to be true with the email account owner. So more on that maybe in another video if people need more details on it. So one other important point I'd like to talk about is, remember like when I hit archive, I have this here with the remember my choice. I know some people probably have that option already remembered if they selected archive or archive and close, and they might be stuck using the delete shortcut with that option. This can be changed in your settings. So click on your avatar, settings, go to preferences, and then in general, you will see prompts. These are all the different pop-ups that can open in Missive. Archiving assigned conversations from your inbox. Mine is currently ask. Yours might be archive and archive and close by default. If you're always changing between archive and close, might be best just to keep ask and have the pop-up show up every time. And that's perfectly fine. There are also other settings you should check as well in the composer part of your settings. So the sending options. Personally, I prefer to keep send and archive by default all the time. When I write an email, I want it to be archived automatically from my inbox and send and close by default. So everything I'm sending, I'm automatically closing as soon as I send, because when I send an email, it's the customer who needs to reply back to me. And when I get a reply, that conversation automatically reopens because there's a new message I need to take care of until I close again the conversation. And my favorite one is the alternate send on CMD, Command Shift on Mac, or Control Shift on Windows. I'll show you what it does. And this is really cool when you have this email that usually you would send and close, but this specific email, you kind of need to still do something about it. So let me go back to this support email I had here and I hit reply. Now I have send and close by default. Of course, let's say I don't want to send and close this. I want to just send a thanks for reaching out. You've reached Missive support. Our dev team will look into your issue later. So I can do Command Shift and you can see now it says send. So I don't have to click here and click on send. I can use the shortcuts to send an email. It'll be Command Enter to send that, but Command Shift Enter will allow you to switch between send and close and send. So Command Shift Enter. Now that conversation still in my inbox, still in my assigned to me. Let's say all I wanted to do with this was to send it to the dev team. I can just change the team, move it to devs, make sure it's moved to team inbox, because if I don't select this, I'm just assigning it to the dev, but I'm archiving the conversation. It needs to be in the team inbox to be visible here. Otherwise, it'll just be visible here and people may just not see it. Good. So now I've used that shortcut to be able to move that conversation, but still send a quick reply. So thanks for watching this deep dive explanation. I hope this was useful. If you have more questions or things we haven't covered in this video, send us an email at support@missiveapp.com. See you in the next one.